और ओम नित्यानंदं परमसुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वंद्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यं एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वधी साक्षीभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। Nityanandam, we welcome all the prince and princess in training of His Divine Holiness Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam, our most beloved Swamiji, and we welcome all the viewers of Nityananda TV, YouTube Live, Facebook Live, and all the registered students of Nityananda Hindu University for this series of sessions on Samraja Lakshmi Pitika, the Agamic scripture revealed by Paramashiva himself in the Akasha Bhairava Tantra. Now we are going to enter into the ninth chapter of the Samraja Lakshmi Pitika, the Navama Patala. So, the ninth chapter is Avarana Devatadi Lakshanam, the Lakshanas of all the Devatas starting from Avarana Devatas. Avarana Devatanam, Avaranas. आवरणानां देवताः आवरणदेवताः आवरणदेवतानां सॉरी आवरणदेवता आदि यस्य सः आवरणदेवतादि आवरणदेवतादीनां लक्षणं आवरणदेवतादि लक्षणं। दिस् इस् दि व्युत्पत्ति आफ् विग्रहवाक्यम् आफ् दिस् समास आवरणदेवतादि लक्षणं। सो वेन् इट् मीन्स् आवरणदेवता, वेन् यु से वि हेव् फोर् words inside of this compounded word, avarana devata adi lakshanam, avarana devata. How you should break up a samasa here? Lakshanam avarana devata, avarana devata adi lakshanam. First it gets split into avarana devata adi lakshanam. Now what do we mean by avarana devata adi? Avarana devata adihi yasya saha, that group, that collection or that group to which avarana devatas are the first. So now avarana devata, what does the word avarana devata? Avaranaanam devata avarana devata or avaranaanam devataha avarana devataha means the devatas of the avarana are the avarana devatas. So this literally means avarana devata adi lakshanam literally means the description of the deities, avarana devatas and other devatas as well. So we'll get into the chapter 9th. We'll get into the 9th chapter. Which, what is the chapter number? 9th chapter. So deva deva virupaksha. वृषभध्वज शंकर साम्राज्य लक्ष्मी मंत्रस्य होम भेदा मया श्रुताः इदानीं श्रोतुमिच्छामि लक्षणानि मनूनपि षडङ्गदेवतादीनां वदस्व वदतां वर साधु साधु जगद्वंद्ये यन्मां त्वं परिपृच्छसि
तत्
तत्तेहं संप्रवक्ष्यामि श्रृणु कल्याणि सादरम् हृदयादि षडंगादि देवतास्तु पुरोदिताः ध्येयास्त्रिरूपधारिण्यः वराभयकराः प्रिये क्रमान् मुक्तेन्दु कांताब्ज हरिनीलानल प्रभाः धनलक्ष्मीः धनघटम् धनलक्ष्मीः धनघटम् कलयन्ती करेण वै ध्येयास्याद्भाग्यलक्ष्मीस्तु दधाना शालिमञ्जरीम् सन्तानलक्ष्मीर्विज्ञेया कटिविन्यस्तबालका सौभाग्यलक्ष्मी स्मर्तव्या मातुलिंग मातुलुंग करा सदा विद्यालक्ष्मीर्विधातव्या करविन्यस्तपुस्तका शौर्यलक्ष्मीश्चिन्तनीया खड्गोद्यकर खड्गोद्यत कराशुभा वीरलक्ष्मी वीरवाद वादिनी सर्वदेवता वंदि बृंदेन विजयलक्ष्मीः नंदित वैभवा इन्द्रस्त्वैरावतारूढो इन्द्रस्तु ऐरावतारूढः वज्रहस्तो हरित्प्रभः रक्तवर्णोऽग्नि रक्तवर्णोऽग्निराख्यातः मेषस्थ शक्तिधारकः ध्येयो दण्डधरश्यामो यमो महिषवाहनः खड्गपाणिः कृष्णवर्णो नैऋतशववाहनः वरुणः पाशभृच्छ्वेत वर्णो मकरवाहनः धावद्धरिण पृष्ठस्थो वायुर्धूमोऽङ्कुशान्वितः वायुर्धूमोऽङ्कुशान्वितः दशाश्वरथगः सोमो गदापाणिशुचिप्रभः गदापाणिशुचिप्रभः ईशानशूलभृत् रक्तवर्णः वृषभवाहनः ईशानशूलभृद्रक्त वर्णो वृषभवाहनः दिक्पालहेतयः कार्याः बद्धाञ्जलिपुटाहृदि तत्तद्धेति धरामूर्ध्नि पुरुषाकृतयः क्रमात् नामानि प्रणवादीनि चतुर्थ्यन्तानि पार्वती नमोद्युतानि मनवः सॉरी नमोयुतानि मनवः प्रोक्तास्तासां मनीषिभिः ऋषिरेषामहं छन्दाम् ऋषिरेषामहं छन्दाम् स्यूह्यान्य क्षरसङ्ख्यया ऋषिरेषामहं छन्दांसि ऊह्यान्यक्षर संख्यया ऊह्यानि अक्षर संख्यया देवता हृदयादीनि कथितानि यथाक्रमम् इत्येवं ते षडङ्गादि देवतानां अनुक्रमात् लक्षणानि मयोक्तानि किमन्यत् श्रोतुमिच्छसि इत्याकाशभैरवाख्ये महाशैवतन्त्रे साम्राज्यलक्ष्मीपीठिकायां आवरणदेवतादिलक्षणम् नाम नवमः पटलः सो द नाइन्थ चैप्टर देवदेव विरूपाक्ष वृषभध्वज शंकर Devi Parvati is calling Paramashiva. So, in the ninth chapter, now Parvati Devi calls Paramashiva in this way. Deva Deva, O the Lord of all Devas, Virupaksha, O the three-eyed one, Vrishabhadhvaja. Vrishabha means the bull, the Nandi. The standing bull, is standing Nandi is called Vrishabha. When the Nandi is seated, it will be called as Nandi. So the one who is having the flag in which Vrishabha, the divine bull, is imprinted is called Vrishabhadvaja. Parameshwara, Lord Paramashiva, has this flag, Vrishabhadvaja. And hence, he is called as Vrishabhadvaja by Devi Parvati. O Shankara, the doer of auspiciousness, the creator of auspiciousness for the whole world. Samrajyalakshmi mantrasya homa bhedaha maya shrutaha. The different varieties of different methods of doing the homa for Devi Samrajyalakshmi has been heard by me. Idanim shrotum ichhami. Now I wish to hear. Idanim now shrotum ichhami. I wish to hear. Lakshanani manu napi. Shadangadi devata dinam vadasva vadatam vara. Now, again Paramashiva, Devi calls Paramashiva, Vadatam, among all the people who speak, you are the Vara, you are the best who, among all the orators, Vadatam Vara, among all the speakers, you are the best in speaking itself. You please reveal to me the Lakshanani. Lakshana means the how something should be. If suppose somebody asks, what is the Lakshana? Lakshana of a right angle, I would say that in one of the angles of the triangle will be 90 degrees. That is a lakshana of the right angle triangle. So lakshana is a definition. Define lakshana means this defined description. That is what you can understand as a mapping of this word lakshana. So lakshanani षडंगादि देवतादीनां मनूनपि लक्षणानि वदस्व. ओ यू टेल रिवील दि फॉर्म्स ऑफ दि षडंगादि देवतास, दि देवतास विच स्टार्ट विथ दि ग्रुप ऑफ देवतास हूज लक्षण आई विश टू हियर आर स्टार्टिंग विथ the Shadanga, the six Anga Devatas. Now Paramashiva starts speaking. Sadhu sadhu jagadvandye. Well, what you are asking is very nice. Jagadvandye, the one who is worshipped by the whole world. Oh, the Devi Parvati who is worshipped by the whole world. Yanmam tvam paripritchasi. Whatever you are asking me, tatteham sampravakshyami. I will tell that to you. Shrinu kalyani sadaram. Listen with deep respect. Oh, Kalyani, the auspicious one. Listen to what I am saying with deep respect. Hridayadi shadangadi devataha tu pura purodhitaha. Hridayadi shadanga devataha. The devatas, the Anga devatas, six Anga devatas, starting with Hridaya. Earlier in the previous chapters, Paramashiva explained about the, told about the Anga devatas in the, while telling the form of Devi Samarajalakshmi itself. Devi Paramashiva told the about the who are all surrounded by Devi Samarajalakshmi, and while explaining the, while revealing the mantra of Samarajalakshmi Devi, also Paramashiva told that how the Anganyasa or the Shadanganyasa has to be done with the six padas, six words of the mantra. So the usually the shadanga, six angas in which the nyasa will be done. Nyasa is touching and invocation of that each devatas. Where it will be done is hridaya, shiras, shikha, kavacha, netratraya, astra, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, astra. So hridayadi shadanga devataha, the word hridayadi shadanga devataha means the six Anga Devatas starting with Hridaya. The rest of it is to be understood as Shiras, Shikha, Kavacha, Netratraya, Astra. So in some places it may not be Netratraya, it may be just Netra. Depending on which Devata, you need to understand whether the Netra, Trinetra Nyasa, the Nyasa for three eyes should be done, or the Nyasa for the two eyes should be done. Purodhitaha, Pura Uditaha. Pura means earlier, previously. Earlier, Uditaha has been told. Devataha, the Hridayadi Shadanga Devatas, tu Puroditaha, Dheyaha, Stri Rupadharinyaha, Varabhaya Karaf Priye. Now, Paramashiva starts telling how they have to be meditated, how the dhyana for this, for these devatas have to be done. Before, earlier, in the previous chapters, Paramashiva told in the about worshipping the Samarajalakshmi Devi in the Yantra, he told worship the Anga Devatas and the Avarana Devatas also. So before, as a part of a standard, typical, any puja, you will have the dhyana, you will have to meditate on the form of the Devata in your heart, in your Ananda Gandha. So you need to know the form of how that Devata will be. So the Devata's form, all the Anga Devatas, how they should be meditated upon, they all should be meditated upon in this way. In they all to be in the form of a assuming a feminine form. Stri Rupa Dharinyaha. As if they are, not as if they are having the form of a stri, feminine form. Vara Abhaya Karaf Priye. They having Abhaya Hasta and Varada Hasta. Kramat Muktendu Kanta Abja Hari Neela Anala Prabhaha Muktendu Kanta Abja Hari Neela Hari Neela Anala Prabhaha. Prabhaha means the divine aura. How, what color their divine aura, each devatas? Kramat, respectively. When it said respectively, you need to understand it starts with Hridaya. So for Hridaya, Shiras, Shikha, Kavacha, Astra, Netra, sorry, Hridaya, Shiras, Shikha, Kavacha, Netra and Astra, the respectively, the devatas having, are all having the Abhaya Hasta and Varada Hasta, and assuming a Stri Rupa, feminine form, and they all having the divine aura with the divine colors, Mukta Endu, full moon. Mukta means liberated, liberated. Indu means moon. Mukta Endu, the Purna Chandra, the Purnima, the full moon, which is fully liberated from all the darkness. Muktendu, Kanta, Kanta, Abja. Next, Abja, Hari, Neela, Anala Prabhaha. All the other devatas, the Hrudaya Devata, Shiro Devata, Shikha Devata, Kavacha Devata. Why I am touching? Too for us to understand, that's all. But the devatas are Hrudaya Devata, Shiro Devata, Shikha Devata, Kavacha Devata, Netra Devata, Nastra Devata. They all have these respective colors. If you go back, the Astra Devata is in the form of, has the Anala Prabha. Anala means fire. Astra invariably is a weapon which goes out and comes back. So Anala Prabha, the Prabha, the divine aura of the Astra Devata is Anala, fire, flame color, which is deep orange flame in color. Neela, the previously before that it's Neela, Neela Prabha, which is prior to that Astra. Before Astra, it is Netra. Netra has the Neela Prabha, divine blue or dark in color. That Devata. Hari means a shade of greenish in color for the Kavacha. Abja means lotus. For the Shikha Devata, the Abja, lotus is the color. Kanta, Kanta Pushpa, the flower, Kanta Pushpa's color is the divine aura of the Shiro Devata. Dhana Lakshmi, next, the title of this chapter itself is Avaranadi Devatadi, Avarana Devatadi Lakshanam. So, the Avarana Devatas, what are all the Avarana Devatas? The Shadanga Devatas, and then what are all the other Devatas that are, they are, who are around Devi Samaraja Lakshmi? They are Ashtalakshmis and the Ashtadikpalakas and their weapons. So the next Paramashiva goes into the explanation about the forms of the Ashtalakshmis. Dhana Lakshmihi Dhanaghatam Kalayanti Karenavai. Dhana Lakshmi holds the Dhanaghatam. Dhana Lakshmi means the Devata, the deity, the Devi, Lakshmi Devi, who bestows Dhanam, literally money. Dhana ghatam means pot, dhana means money. The pot from which she showers money, if the pot which is filled with or which can keep on giving continuously all money that is needed for every being who are prays to her. She holds the dhana ghatam in her hand. Dheya syat bhagya lakshmi stu. Bhagya lakshmi should be meditated, should be contemplated upon in this way. Dadhana Shalimanjarim, she holds the grains. Shali means rice, the flowers, and see, if you, the rice, the paddy crop is grown, and when it is ready for harvest, when it is ready for harvest, or when the seeds, partly the seeds from the flowers have started growing, partly there are flowers are also there, that she is holding this Bhagya Lakshmi. Earlier, Paramashiva used the word Dhana Lakshmi, Dhanya Lakshmi. Dhanya Lakshmi is being referred to here as Bhagya Lakshmi because Bhagya means auspiciousness or Bhagya means fortune, prosperity. Prosperity is always measured in terms of agricultural produce and not in terms of money. So here, Paramashiva uses the word Bhagya Lakshmi for Dhanya Lakshmi. Santana Lakshmihi Vijneya Kativinyasta Balaka. Santana Lakshmi should be meditated upon, she should be contemplated in your heart in the form having Kati. Kati means hip. Vinyasta means touching. Kativinyasta Balaka. In her Kati, in her hip, near her hip, there is a child, small child. Balaka. Balaka is in Strilinga. Hence, a female child being seated on her lap, on the laps of Santana Lakshmi, who is touching the hips of Samaraja Lakshmi Devi. This is the form Santana Lakshmi Devi should be meditated upon. Saubhagya Lakshmi hi smartavya matulunga karasada. Saubhagya Lakshmi should be, the form of Saubhagya Lakshmi should be meditated as if she is holding the matulunga. Matulunga is one of the ayudhas. Matulunga mayat keta bhibratti namaha is one of the namavali of Lakshmi. Ashtotra Shatanamavali of Mahalakshmi, which starts with Shriyai Namaha, it there. So Namavali Matulunga Mayatketa Bhibrati Namaha. Vidya Lakshmihi Vidhatavya. Vidya Lakshmi should be meditated. The form of Vidya Lakshmi, how she should be remembered. Karavinyasta Pustaka. In she as holding a pustakam. Pustakam means a book. A book, not necessarily the bound book. Book refers to here the palm leaves all bunched together, the palm leaves in which all the scriptures are written and they are bunched. That is the pustakam. So, Vidya Lakshmi holds the book in her hand. Shaurya Lakshmi hi chintaniya khadga udyata kara shubha. Shaurya Lakshmi. Shaurya Lakshmi, Shaurya means the Shura. Shura means the ability to, the one who conquers. Shaurya Lakshmi, the ability to conquer something. Shaurya Lakshmi, chintaniya, she should be always remembered. How? Khadga. Khadga means sword. Udyata, holding the sword upward, not on her hip. When why Parmashiva tells Udyata kara shubha, it is Shaurya Lakshmi is holding the sword up in her arm, not in her, in the cover of the sword is not inside of the cover. It is taken out and she is holding. Karashubha. Veera Lakshmihi Veeravada Vadini Sarvadevata. Veera Lakshmihi Veeravada Vadini Sarvadevataha. Sarvadevata. Veera Lakshmi should be meditated upon as having the ability, holding the ability. Veeravada means the speech, which courage is speech. Veera, courage. Vada is speech. Such kind of a courageous speech is spoken by her. Vadini means the one who speaks. Sarvadevata, she is the embodiment of all devatas. Vandi Brindena Vijaya Lakshmihi. Vandi Brindena Vijaya Lakshmihi. Meena Vijaya Lakshmihi Nandita Vaibhava. By all the groups. Vrinda or Brinda means cluster or group. Group of all the Vandis who are, all these Vandis are worshipping Vijaya Lakshmi. She should be meditated always upon. How she should be, this Devata Vijayalakshmi should be meditated. She, as if she is bowed down, worshipped by all the groups, so many number of Vandis. Indrastu Airavata Arudha. Indra, after the Ashtalakshmis, the next comes Indra the Ashtadikpalakas. Indrastu Airavata Arudha. Indra, as if riding or seated on the Airavata. Airavata is the divine gaja, divine elephant of Devaloka. Veera Lakshmihi, sorry, Indrastu Airavata Rudha Vajrahasto Haritprabhaha. Vajrahastaha, he holds Vajra in his hands. Haritprabhaha, he has a divine green of green aura. Raktavarno Agni Rakhyato. What Paramashiva tells from the 10th shloka, Raktavarno, Raktavarnaha, Agnirakhyataha. Next Devata in the Ashtadikpalakas. After Indra is Agni. If you start, Indra is the Devata whose the Dikpalaka for Purva, East. Then for the southeast, which is the Agneya dik. You should not say Agneya. Agneya is called Agneya because the Adidevata, the presiding deity, is Agni. So for the southwest, Agni is the Devata. How this Devata, Agni, should be meditated upon, Paramashiva reveals in the 10th shloka, which will be continuing in the further sessions. So with this, we offer our gratitude at the feet of His Divine Holiness Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashiva and conclude this session with the chanting of the Purna Mantra. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Tatsat Sarvam Bhagavat Shri Nityananda Paramashiva Padukarpanamastu Om Nityanandam.